Sir, I remember 3rd January 2013 in Kolkata when we launched the Science Technology Innovation Policy 2013, sir. And I remember your remarkable address when you urged us scientists, it is time to get back the Nobel Prizes, sir. And there was a lot of discussion about that later in terms of the new challenges that we have. So after you left, there was this discussion, panel discussion. And in that discussion, we looked at the Science Technology Innovation Policy. Interesting, sir, 1958 were the Science Policy Resolution, 83 Technology Policy Resolution, 2003 Science and Technology Policy. But now we are talking about science, technology, and innovation. Yeah. So the challenge is research converts money into knowledge, but innovation converts knowledge into money. We have been doing the first very well, but in the second, sir, we have been missing. In fact, in the panel discussion I mentioned, Sir C.V. Raman had the Raman effect, the discovery, but Raman scanner was created by the Americans, not by us, sir. Sir J.C. Bose was the one who created platform for wireless, the iron mercury, iron coherer, the scientific breakthrough, but Sir Marconi was the one who was credited with wireless. So Indian ideas have created wealth elsewhere, not here. That is because we have not completed the innovation chain. And that is the thrust of that policy, sir. That's the first point I want to make. The second point is that we are waking up to this reality now. Prime Minister, our Honorable Prime Minister has announced the Indian decade of innovation now, 2000 to 2010. Basically, in which new agenda for innovation is being set. Sir, Prime Minister's National Innovation Council has been set up. Mr. Sam Pitroda is the chairman. Both of us happen to be members. Sir, in your former role as finance minister, you are kind enough to do something for National Innovation Council. 14 November 2011, sir, you launched that Indian Inclusive Innovation Fund. 100 crore. I'm very happy to tell you, sir, that you had asked us to get more. You just said, I'm giving you 100 crore, go and get more. So we have got now 500 crore, and the fund will be launched in a couple of months' time, the Inclusive Innovation Fund. So the dictionary of innovation is changing today, and there are new words that are coming up. Inclusive innovation, reverse innovation, frugal innovation, Gandhian innovation. I mean, and nanovation, indicating the way India has been innovating. Sir, in Harvard Business Review, I and C.K. Prahlad, that happened to be his last paper, wrote a paper called Innovation's Holy Grail, where we talk about how India has innovated. Sir, we always had scarcity, but we had aspiration also. And combination of scarcity and aspiration led us to do things, getting more from less for more and more people, not just for more and more profit. In fact, that paper has led to a lot of thinking, including in the Western world now, where the age of abundance is giving way to age of austerity. And there's a way in which rest of the world is looking at India. So the second part of what I wanted to say was that this challenge of the way India has done innovation is something that is being looked at by the rest of the world, and we have an opportunity to create leadership. The last point I want to make before I pass on to Professor Anil Gupta is the following. Innovation need not be looked at just as something that is reserved for the top of the pyramid, but the base of the economic pyramid. How do we sort of help? So 2.6 billion people with income levels of less than $2 a day. Their economic capacity is very low. So can we think in terms of income inequalities? Yes, of course, they are rising, and in some countries more than anywhere else. So as you know, in China, the top 10% has 34% share of the economy, and bottom has 2.4%. But income inequalities leading, finally vanishing, will take a long time. Can we give excess equality? That means access equality despite income inequality, that is inclusive innovation. And within that context, sir, we look at 1.3 billion Indians as not 1.3 billion mouths, but 1.3 billion minds, because everyone can basically innovate. So that is the basic background on which National Innovation Foundation was set up in the year 2000. I was privileged to be its chairperson, but the real hero is here. I call him Mr. Innovator of India, Professor Anil Gupta, and sir, you will hear him. His journey started 25 years ago with the Honeybee network, and then came Shrusti, Shodhayatras. He moves through the villages, and you will hear some of that in few minutes in terms of what he's discovering, the way our villagers innovate, the way illiterate innovate. We give these awards, more than 100,000 applicants come, out of which 30 awards are given, and many times, sir, 50% of them are illiterate. And sir, we are most grateful to you that on 7 March, you agreed to give away the National Innovation Foundation Awards and also hold the exhibition so that people at large can come and see these innovations. The last point I want to make is the young India. Half of India, 55% is less than 25. And so the interesting thing about the young is that they really fulfill the definition of an innovator. One definition of innovator is one who does not know it cannot be done. So we have half of India which does not know it cannot be done, and they're also impatient. And therefore, one of the thrust of our presentation is, sir, what we can do to stimulate these young to innovate and catapult India to sort of a great position. So, sir, our thrust has been during your presidency, sir, 2012-17, how we can create a legacy of innovation. And with that brief introduction, I'll request Professor Anil Gupta to make the presentation.
Sir, the question that we're asking is that what would this presidency be remembered for in 2012 to 2017? And one of our submission is that it should be remembered not only for engagement with millions of young people in the country, but also motivating them to get actively involved in social transformation. There is a tremendous impatience and aspiration among the young people to be involved. They are much less patient with the problem unsolved than our generation was, and that is the most redeeming part of our society. I'll give you an example, sir. This boy from Kolkata sent us an idea that many times when rickshaw is being driven, the rickshawala has to get down and pull the rickshaw manually. Why can't the passenger also co-pedal? In boats, we do that. We got a rickshaw fabricated, and when he came for award from Dr. Kalam in November, we got showed him a prototype. Now that shows that is a compassion. That is a we have all seen this problem. We didn't know anything about it, but he is the young child, class 12, who has thought about it. Another example, sir. There's a boy from Jalgaon, class 2. He said, why can't I harness the energy of the windmill for having my ceiling fan work? Just invented and thought about a bevel gear. Now, whether it is class 2 or class 12, children are coming out with fantastic solutions, sir. And these are children who will make this country very different. We also have a platform called as techpedia.in, which has 140,000 project summaries and titles of engineering projects done by 450,000 students. So we don't want any student of our country to do what has been done before. The originality question should go up. The problems of micro and small medium industries must be posed to them in their final year project. They should take real life problems. We want them really to build collaborative culture and solve these problems. This could be one of the game changers, sir. If our students will be really engaging with social problems, then they can really bring about change. There's a COCO model where if students have not finished a project to its product level, somebody else will take it over in another institute and carry it forward. So one of the proposals that we are building is, sir, that both through the central universities and also through the state universities which governors steer them, could we create National Innovation Club in every university, sir? And there are four dimensions, sir. Search, spread, sense the roots, and celebrate. Searching, they will do the mapping of creativity and innovation, sir. In their hinterland, they will be able to identify. They will go to the villages, go to the slums, find out creative people. They will share with them the ideas from other regions of the country, which will help in integration, which will help fertilize their mind. They will also identify the persistent problems which our society has not solved. Sir, take the case of a cobbler. He uses the tripod, the triangle of the iron, which was designed when shoes were made of leather and when nails were fitted in them. Today we don't have shoes with nails, but he still has the same tool which was designed several hundred years ago. And we have not thought about it. He provides service to us, but his tools have not changed. Such problems have to be put on the agenda of the students. They must come out with a stitching device, an adhesive which can be used and compressed. They have to come out with a solution. And finally, they will also recognize the achievers in different social segments. Sir, once you engage, this is our ambition, sir, that at least 5 million young people, you will be engaging with them during 5 years, sir. And these young people will carry this message, sir, that they have to transform the society, they have to declare no patience with the inertia, and they will then bring the achievers of our society in different segments to the education. So in a classroom, there was no formal mechanism to bring achievers in different fields. But once these kids go around and find out the achievers, invariably they will ask questions to their teachers about, so-and-so has done so much without our help. Could we not extend a little help? So this possibility that these young people will start discussing them in the classroom is very buoyant, very poignant with potential. So we have this chapter. And then we also expect, sir, that these students will develop the largest, and the faculty will develop the open source, high quality, multi-language, multi-media content for education. We must be the provider, largest provider in the world of open source content, sir. That is Indian legacy, Indian development contribution to the world. And this is possible, sir. Educational institutions can do that. The second dimension of the legacy is, sir, inspired teacher network. Sir, we have all been inspired by some teachers in our life. But there is no roll call of these teachers, sir. We have never kept record of these teachers. Sir, once in a year or twice, whenever convenient to you, if you would address these teachers, inspired teachers, they don't need anything, sir. They do it because swantai sukhai, for their own inner happiness they teach. I teach 7-8 courses at a time, and not that I am not required to. I mean, if I teach 2 at this stage, will be enough. But there are a lot of teachers who teach because they enjoy teaching. They want to remain in contact with young people. And this is a social capital for our society, sir. Once you fire their imagination, they will create benchmarks for everybody else to follow. It doesn't cost money, but it requires tremendous investment of inspiration to these inspired teachers. They are the ones who have to be heard for making the society different. Second is, sir, that we use technology students and other students to map the problems of MSME. There is a work on metal work somewhere, some institutions, fishermen and women, they are facing problems. How do their nets last longer? What should they paint on that? The students have to work on that and see, can they increase the life of the nets they use? So we would like to have students in their final year taking up a real life problem, and they get credit for that. We also want, sir, that every student of college must make at least one lesson in one language for one subject of any one class of children, school children. Just one lesson, sir. In 4 years is there, ek lesson banate, sir. Bengali mein, Marathi mein, kisi bhi language. So we cannot change the teachers in primary school, sir. 6.5 lakh villages, sir. But we can get the content reach all the 6.5 lakh villages. And when the good quality content will... Sir, there are 1.5 lakh post offices, there are 6.5 lakh villages. Sir, we can reach every single village. We can reach every single village through the postal network. One post office for 4 villages, sir. It is feasible, sir. And they're all going to be connected with broadband anyway. Sir, post office mein content pahunch jayega, wahan se bachche le lenge. If we can't deliver teachers, at least we can get high quality content that I and you would appreciate for our children and our grandchildren should be available to every child of the country, sir. That is something that is doable. And we can work together and make it happen, sir. Because you are the visitor of the top central universities, they attract the top students of the country, and state governors have the other institutions. Sir, ek lesson banana hai sirf. We're asking only one lesson to be made. For one subject, kisi bhi subject mein, kisi bhi class ka, kisi bhi topic par, ek lesson local Indian language mein banna chahiye, sir. So that we can provide the largest pool of open source content for our children. So that no child will suffer from lack of access to quality material. We cannot do anything else about the rest of the system, but we can get the materials, sir. And this open source solution, sir, will be our gift to the world at large, sir. We would believe that we get this educational resource, other technological resource which society wishes to share in open source. In NIF, sir, we have a grassroots technological innovation acquisition fund. We acquire the IP rights of the technologies and make it open source available to MSME at low cost or no cost. Same thing we can share with the rest of the world. So when you're visiting Africa, Latin America, or any country, we should be contributor of these open source solutions to that country. That apart from everything else, here are these solutions available to you. Please play with them. If they are useful, use them. We don't expect any reciprocity. Unilaterally, we will contribute these public goods, sir, to the society at large. There are some challenges, sir. Gandhiji in 1929 gave a challenge, sir. That was the first challenge award announced in our country, sir. He announced an award of 7,700 pounds. At that time, it was worth 1 lakh rupee for redesigning the charkha. And there was a committee he set up in Khadi Prayog Samiti. Mr. Banker was one of the members. And he said that if the committee doesn't reach a solution, he will be the final decider. He allowed them to file a patent. He was conscious of the patent at that time. He said, you can have patent, but if you want award, you have to transfer the patent to the Samiti so that it should become an open source solution. He gave his specification. Sir, that value of that award today will be 10 crores. Now, issue is not amount, sir. Issue is that those problems with which we have been living with have to be posed to the rest of the country. You know, sir, I will show you later on, paddy plant transplantation, sir. Paddy transplantation is done by women in a back-bending posture, even today, manually keeping their feet in the water. They develop ulcers on their feet, sir. Back pains. We don't have a manual transplanter for the women. If this becomes, last year, through this challenge, somebody in this country will solve this problem, sir, if we give the challenge. So every year, we will take your inspiration, throw those challenges which can reduce the drudgery, and the whole nation will apply for that and we'll give award to them, sir, every year. So that some problem we will decide we will not live with them. Be it cobbler's problem, be it a woman who's transplanting paddy, or tea leaf picking, sir. You know, sir, in that region, when they pick the leaf from the bush, they keep it like this. Sir, it is against the gravity. 2,000, 3 times 10, your hand goes, there's a pain here, sir. There's a pain here. We cannot expect, sir, that this will continue. We must find ways in which, without drudgery, the same quality of tea leaf can be plugged. So we would wish that these challenges are thrown for persistent inertia in our society, the problem with which we have lived for so long, we will not live any longer, and young people will be challenged to that. Third is, sir, out of 100 days of employment that is given, at least even if 5 days are